So what's up, the bunk guys? Let's take that really fast talking about the video I want to do. Again, I'm looking really that one though. Of course, we did get some new news or new Debobbity. Yeah, that makes sense. Oh, Debobbity. Bobbity and Deborah, of course. It's pretty late at night, though. So, of course, we've got to be kind of a little bit quiet. But we did get some new news for them. Of course, they are coming to JP. But sooner or later, a lot of people think they're going to be with the new Dungeon Bower Chain mode. But, like, that could be a possibility, or, you know, Battlefield, because they kind of get mentioned out a little bit. I never got some new internet Dragon Ball stage, just, you know, announced. We didn't get, like, the full details or anything like that. If it does, then I'll, you know, make a video on it. But, yeah, we'll try to go over everything really, really really fast, really quick though, of course. But yeah, we didn't get that much info-ish, but we got info for them, of course. They are pretty good though. I heard they're kind of free to play. I heard they aren't. It makes sense they are kind of free to play because last we had like summonable, because again, like before, I mean, they kind of go back and now they're going back and forth between Prime Battle Cullen, the summonable. No, he was free to play. LR Vegeta and Apple were summonable. They're free to play. The next one's gonna probably be summonable because everybody thought we could get like a Gohan or a Kid Buu. I was like, yeah, either one will work. Of course, I will go over them really quick. Shouldn't take them that long to go through. So Deborah and Debara to be. Why are you messing up the names? Jeez. So then they do Budget Bar, Category 2 plus 3, everything up 130. Kind of get her a little bit, but 170 would have been good. So the first super attack called Cult of Damage, still super attack. Good. The second one does Mega Colossal. Medium chance. Mega Colossal damage with the high chance stun. That's good. Makes sense because, you know, every attack, Bobby does kind of stun. So now we just need a new Bobby card, like a pre-pre. Yeah, I think we need like a pre-Yakon, maybe? We don't have a good, like, Spoble Bitch and Yamu. I thought we could use a new Bobby because we don't really have a good one in the game. But they never release, like, new like, units with its power banner, so just saying my opinion. They never really do that. So they do what else? The passive. Kid plus 3, and attack defense plus 88%, gives additional kid plus 3, and attack defense plus 40% if their target has an attack down or defense down status, gains additional kid plus 3, and high chance from a crit. If your target is stunned or sealed, stunned or sealed status, which you'll probably kind of know, Majin Power category allies get kid 3, everything up, attack defense plus 30%. So they really are good. They're insane. So I guess when they have the attack down status and stuff like that, I guess, confirms it right there. When they have the attack down or defense down status, they will give you an additional, they're basically giving themselves key a lot, so they will really struggle. Because a lot of LOs nowadays, again, they're either made like a new mode, insurance or battle road, again, with little stuff like that, of course. That's what every LO is being made of, bro, nowadays, so yeah. Again, if you guys don't know what the Majin Power category is, it's basically this category. It's basically all booze, 21, and of course, did I say oop? There's a basically with booze, oops, and of course, 21. So yeah, again, it'll probably be, it was really based around boo. So we need like a new boo tank, we need a new Buhan. We actually do. And Boo Icolo. Because we already have the Fat Boo Imperial Evil Boo. We could use a new standalone Imperial Evil Boo. This one isn't bad. These two aren't bad. I thought we could use like a new nowadays one nations and typical little stuff like that, of course. But the category isn't that bad, it's just booze and stuff like that. I'll have like Wall Sand and all whatever. They're really good. They're insane. They're going to be giving themselves key, attack and defense a lot. This is a bit like Gotenks and Boo, of course, with Boo, giving himself like Gotenks and Boo, kind of giving himself key and stuff like that. Of course, having a high chance and stuff like that to stun. For Gotenks like him, he'll keep getting after attack or defense over and over and over again, no matter what. So that's why they kind of go around like Gotenks. Of course, LR is always picked off like the best unit or previous unit or whatever. So yeah, it will be available with the new Dokken Battle Chain event coming up. I'll have a good example of Solar Mars. But yeah, they're all really good. So yeah, links are Master of Magic, Majin, Revive Gen Plan, Resurrection Plan, Reincarnation, whatever. It's basically like Pui Yakon, all that Majin Vegeta, all those links and stuff like that. The hip, Majin Power, it really should have been Majin Power. Everybody who's been possessed, has the Majin symbol on it. Pui Deborah, they'll encourage more units. New Majin Vegeta, because they can actually do the easy area for that Fat Boo, a physical Fat Boo, and take Majin Vegeta. They should do that. Brutal Beatdown, Nightmare, Fear and Faith, and Legendary Power. The categories are Blood and Blue Arc Saga, and yeah, Blood and Blue Arc, Joy Forces, and Terrifying Conquerors. I've seen them. Everybody using the Terrifying Conquerors. Blood and Blue Arc, I mean, for instance, like that, they're not going to really link well with Joy Forces. Mixed bag here and there, but yeah, of course, we're here for JP. We do have the official announcement. For, of course, the Infinite Dragon Ball stages, it's been announced, Infinite Dragon Ball Stage 7. A lot of people think this is going to be my Jabu arc. Makes sense, that will be good and awesome. Of course, we have some new battlefield slash, you know, bosses for, like, new Dragon Ball chain, I guess. We have a new Super Saiyan Kid Trunks. That was, like, Marjan Dwarf themed. Super Saiyan 3 Goku, Majin, Golden Frieza, Slug, Super Saiyan Vegeta, Metacolor, Border Magetta, Cyborg Tell, and so, the new Infinite Dragon Ball stages, I guess? That's how it's gonna be? So, it's like going back and forth just like that between the sagas and filler and stuff like that. Can we say Infinite Dragon Ball stages, the same missions as previous? 7 or more stages of new category allies, 70 goes full tournament. We're just basically doing the Dragon Ball chain mode thing every single day. Okay. Yeah, 20 stones, stickers, great. Potential orbs. So, yeah, this is all just what we want to go to say. Again, though, really more of a shorter video. But overall, though, I mean, the Deborah, again, Deborah and Babidi are really good. Again, though, they are just going to really be basically, again, they'll give themselves key a lot. Maybe give themselves, but like, you know, if the attack, like, if it's put stunned or sealed, or when attack is down or defensive down, they're going to be really good, though, like, there. So, I mean, you're probably going to put see, like, this first one of the facets a lot. But, a lot, and then after that, they're gonna give themselves a lot of key. But overall, though, really good. Again, they're gonna be basically working around with this category. We just got Awakening, he's good. Because the new Joker Plus one's good. Everybody in the album has their full version. 21's good. Other women have her. The free play one's still good. Overall, they're pretty good unit. I don't think they're bad. They're good at the free play unit and stuff like that. Yeah, I feel like they're built like that, though. But again, though, they really never. They always use, you know, LRs always been flat boosts. Boost this, boost. But, again, I'm on little stuff like that, of course. Again, those hundred really want to go today. Again, though, that's cool. They're awesome. They are really good. They're really, honestly, not really RNG based. They're kind of like Go Tanks, but just HGO. Yeah, Extreme HGO didn't even need it. They just had like LR, Apple, and Vegeta. Kind of weird. I feel like they should be in tech, but then they just got a tech unit. Or physical. Or yeah, probably a physical problem would have worked better. But they just had LR from the Krillin. Yeah, a lot of stuff going back and forth. Yeah. See you guys later, though. Thanks so much for watching. Have a great day. Great life. All the cool jokes. Again, though. See you guys later, though. It's out.